Hi. Oh, what time do you get off of work?
I don't have a job.
No, I know. The Hang! Tried the rice?
No.
Oh. Welcome to The Hang. I'm your host, Mike Audette, and this is your other host of the show, Tony Pasquarello. This is our very first episode, and we're very excited to be here with all of you. It's the holiday season, and I can't think of a better way to celebrate it than with your two best buds, Mike and T, down here at the station.
You know, Mike, I couldn't agree with you more. You know what I love about the holiday season, besides getting to wear all your heavy clothes, is that no more sports cars on the road. You don't gotta worry about it.
That's a great point, Tony, because, you know, the thing about sports cars, I'll be driving around in the otter months, you know, and I'll see...
The otter months? Don't you mean the otter months?
That's what I said, the H is silent. So I'm driving around in the otter months, and I see all these cars, they're all like Mustangs and Corvettes and Vipers, and to be quite frank with you, I don't like the type of people that drive cars like that. I think they're snobbish and stuck up, and I think the winter months driving these people away from the streets because they can't use their cars, I think that is your ultimate Christmas
miracle.
I like that. Like a guy like you, like a big Italian guy, what does your family do around the holiday times?
Being a big Italian guy, I have a pretty big Italian family, so we all get together, you know, we go grocery shopping, get all some fresh loaf. And we'll just make a really big Christmas dinner and then take it down to the homeless shelter and eat it in front of everybody.
Wait, did I hear that correctly? You take it to the homeless shelter and you eat it in front of the people. Is this a joke or is this serious?
Because
I don't think that's a funny joke at all. That's really, I take offense to that. I don't think that's appropriate at all. It's pretty funny. All right, Tony, T, I'm sorry. Let me ask you this. You know, in the holiday times, growing up as a kid, I never really got anything really spectacular for Christmas. I got nice little trinkets here and there, but I never really got a Christmas miracle. And that's what I'm looking for this year. And I was wondering if you could bring that to me. If I, you know, will you just give me one Christmas wish? If I just tell you something I want, will you grant it? Just one thing.
Go ahead. What is it? Anyway.
Go ahead. This is what I want. I want you and me to go head-to-head in a Neanderthal club fight. What do you say? I don't think that's asking too much. Is that so much for a little boy to ask for? Come on. It's the first show. I want it to be a groundbreaking first start. What do you say?
A club fight?
Club fight, yeah.
If it's a club fight, then consider me in the VIP, but I'm in.
Appreciate it. Thank you. Yeah. The Hang! Set your eyes as I am.
Hey, cool question for you.
Okay.
So you're channel surfing, looking for something to on the TV, and you come across two different channels. One of them has your favorite show on, and the other one has like a pretty good show on. The channel that has your favorite show is in a commercial break right now, but the other channel has the show on, but it's only a pretty good show. Which one would you watch?
I would wait for my favorite show.
Yeah, you must really like that show.
Welcome back to The Hang. If you're still tuned in, I feel sorry for you. I'm just kidding. This next guest was not easy to get, so I really hope you do appreciate it. He is actually the founder of the National Geographic Summer Snake Safari Program, and he's won numerous awards for his dissertation in 1996, which is entitled Cutting the Crust. So without further ado, please put your hands together for Dr. Peter Bobby Jefferson. I really appreciate you coming. Great to have you.
No problem. Actually, he's calling. Peter's my father's name. Okay. Call me PB and J.
Oh, my apologies.
Okay, no PB and J.
No, sure. So how are things? How you been?
Oh, everything's great. Just years. Down here. So, yeah, it's great. It was a great flight.
How are the kids? Kids all right?
Kids are great. All 14 of them. Yeah.
14? I thought I remember you having two or three last time.
No, I mean I have three, you know, official kids. I mean the rest are just my snakes. I love my snakes.
Oh, okay.
More than my kids, really. You know, when you're in the tub together, you're just washing each other. It's great times, you know. It's great times.
That's lovely. Good for you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, this guy owns a snake restaurant. He's a snake chef. He started his restaurant back in, what was it, 2001, up in northern Chicago. The place is called, it's called Sliders.
Sliders.
I've never been there, but I got the menu. Just want to take a quick look at it. If you look at the cover, you see you got the Python pepperoni pizza. And I've really never seen anything quite like this. It's pretty spectacular. So let's just take a look at the menu real quick. Just read off a couple of items. So for appetizers, we've got cream of cobra.
Yeah.
Anaconda bites.
Yeah.
Gardener snake salad.
Yeah.
Sliders.
Yeah, that's my favorite. It's
that's
delicious.
What it's called. Nice. Yeah. So some like entrees.
I make it myself. Nice. I make everything myself.
Filet of fang.
Oh yeah, children's favorite.
And snake and potatoes.
Snake and potatoes.
Nice. And then,
snake and taters.
In the drinks, I see this thing here called snake soda.
Oh.
I've never had it, but I've read some good reviews about that online. Would you care to? Would you just kind of describe the process and what you go through to make that particular beverage?
Let me just say Jesus blessed that snake soda. It's just delicious. Basically, what we do, we go down to this nice little factory in Illinois. In like 1987, I went down there when I was still a lad.
Right.
And I saw the potential of this place. I saw it. And it was basically a dried milk factory. But in the back, they had a bunch of piles of like bad dried milk. You know,
right.
Not like it's bad, like it'll make you sick, but like it's bad, like it doesn't taste no good, you know?
Right.
And so I took the dried milk, because they don't like it, they don't want it, you know, what do they, I don't even know why they
kept
it,
I don't even know.
But I took it, you know, and I wasn't officially invited there, but that's a different story.
No, I was wrong, you're right, just keep going.
Okay.
Don't make things more complicated.
So I took the dried milk, I brought it, I took like a half a gallon, all right, few gallons of Tabasco sauce. It just gives it a nice ting, and it's just, it's delicious. Then,
I'm sorry, hang on one sec. I just got a text. My ferret actually just died, so we're going to have to take a quick commercial break, and we'll be right back. I'm going to have Tony take over for the next set, but make sure you stay tuned, because this guy, he's actually going to have a few live snakes on the set for the next set. So it's really going to be something special, so please stay tuned with us, and we'll be right back with The Hang.
The Hang.
And we're back on The Hang. I'm your co-host, Big T, here with a good friend of ours, PB&J.
You can just call me Peter.
Alright, Petey, you want to show us what you got here?
Hang! This is my family. These are my snakes. Right here is the Vigus julis, known as a prize jewel in all of India. It kills about 10 people a week. That's 10 people a week. You would think they would have found a way to get rid of it. Right here is the Willibo Andy. The Willibo Andy, very dangerous in parts of Mexico. What we got?
What's this? What is this? This is the autopsy report for Mike's favorite. It says it died from snake bites.
You son of a bitch. Your snake killed my ferret.
Whoa. Could have been anybody's snake, man.
What are you talking about? I just heard the autopsy.
Doesn't mean it was his snake. Could have been anybody's snake.
Well, I don't care. I'm going to kill him.
Yeah? You're going to kill him? gonna have to go through me first.
You're in the VIP?
Better believe I'm in the VIP.
We'll be right back.
Looks like my wish is coming true, bitch. Tom. Come on. Please, it doesn't have to be this way.
That's what you wanted. Exactly what you wanted.